Started.
What's up, Roth?
Hey, Makito. What's going on, man?
Nothing. I've been wanting to do an intro video for a while to kind of explain what's going on with the channel.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea. We should let everyone know who we are, what we're all about.
Yeah. And so, I don't know. That's what we're doing now. Well, we're waiting for my teacher, my 3-Don teacher, to come and review some games.
Yep. So, we are members of the Massachusetts Go community, and we are both sick and tired of being... So, how strong are you?
2Q AGA, about 3Q KGS.
Okay, and I'm 12Q AGA and about 12 or 11Q online.
Which, I actually started playing Taijiam because... Insente plays on Taijo. I decided to put myself as 3Q, and like I won all three games like very easily, so I can see myself going up very quickly on that site. I'm kind of excited.
Yeah, so like many Go players, we want to get better at Go, and our philosophy is that the best way to do that is publishing videos to solidify things we learn, like Tesogy, Life and Death, game reviews, and just publish all that up so it can help others as well as us.
Yeah, when I was in college the past year, I was, you know, I was studying anatomy and biology and chemistry, and I was really good at it, but that's just because I studied. And a lot of people saw me being good at it, so they would continuously ask to study with me before tests and stuff. And so because I was teaching people, I had to learn the stuff even more. Like, I had to be confident in what I was talking about, right? And, I had to show off to the ladies that I knew what I was talking about.
Yeah, the ladies. That's what it's all about.
It's so true, though. Like, girls like smart guys when you're in college. Maybe not so much in high school, but definitely in college.
Yeah.
Point being is that I had to work harder to teach what I was talking about. And because I was reviewing it constantly with other people, I learned it. And I became better at it, right? And so that was my influence for making this channel, was that if I learn it, then I should learn it a couple more times and make like a SGF file of it. And then once I make the video, I find that it really concretes, like it makes me learn. It forces me to learn it better.
Yeah. So because I'm the weaker player, Mikito's been giving me assignments. And the most recent one is to compile SGFs that sort of illustrate the idea of a life and death I learned, or a Tesogy. And, you know, make that shareable so that we could then make a video out of it. And I also tend to think that repetition is the best way to learning. In fact, it's probably the only way to actually have useful knowledge that you can bust out.
Yeah, I actually had to take psychology this semester. And, like, the chapter on learning was you need to... physically, like, read it, you know, how you would in a book. Like, let's say we were talking about like Left 4 Death or Tetsuji, right? You would read a pattern out, right? And you would like learn it, but you'd only learn it for that short amount of time. It's not like you'd remember it like 4 days later, you know, move for move.
Exactly.
And so you need to learn it. Chances are you need to reread it again. And then if you're physically putting it on the board or making an SGF, then that allows you to get your sense of touch, sight, and, you know, not, you're not tasting it, but but once you make the video and then you review it and listen to the video, you're also getting learning from listening, right?
Right. And we always want to listen to ourselves talk, so there's no chance you won't watch the video you yourself made.
Well, it's, you know, I'll bring that up in 1 second. But yeah, in psychology, they teach you that if you learn physically, looking, and audio, then you'll be able to make it more concrete in your mind and your memory. And so by doing these videos, that's really been helping me a lot. And, you know, I assume it's helping you too.
Absolutely. I definitely feel stronger as I go into games. And I think that might be because rather than reading something in a book where it's in a different context, then it feels totally different to read something in a book than it is to like be in a game, in a situation, and actually have to produce this knowledge rather than just like absorb it. And I think that's part of why like playing out in an SGF, like in a demo, the position itself is so much more helpful towards actually getting better at playing Go, as opposed to like knowing things about Go, if that makes sense.
Yeah, and you know what? You brought up some memories that like frustrated me a lot back in when I was studying a year or two ago, right? Mm-hmm. I would read through the Tetsuji book, and I would read like 4 or 5 patterns a day, maybe. Mm-hmm. Maybe not a day, but like in one sitting, right? I would read like 4 patterns. Mm. And then I would play them on the board as I was reading, but it's not like I continuously replayed them, right? Mm-hmm. I only did them once and then I was done. So it might have introduced me to the new like moves and things like that, but it's not like I learned them well enough to play in games right off the bat.
Yeah.
And so because I'm making these videos now, I physically read it once. Then the next day I come to it and read it again. And then I make the video, you know, after I feel very confident about what I'm talking about. And so that allows me to do it 3 times. And 3 is kind of like the magical number when it comes to learning.
Yeah, I'd be curious to know if there's some like actual biological reason for 3 being so good, you know.
Yeah, yeah. And what's even better is now that I've been like doing the videos, I've been seeing it in my games more often. And I get to point it out when I'm doing my self-review videos and stuff. And that's like really fun to me. I've mentioned it plenty of times and you pointed it out.
Oh, yeah. You're all about the seeing what you learn come to fruition.
Yes, yes. That's exactly it. It makes me feel like I'm not wasting my time. When I see like, oh, I studied this like the other day and I got to use it. Nice.
Oh, yeah. Progress is always the best motivator.
But in one of the self-reviews, we did, you know that the wing, the Ni Rensei wing formation Fuseki we were learning?
Mm-hmm.
In one of the reviews me and you looked over last night, I got to use some of that, right?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't remember why it was bad the way he played. So I actually went back to my video review and like figured out why. And like I was like, yeah, I get to use my video to like, you know, review my game and stuff. So
yeah, got to keep it practical so you can even bust it out like actually when you need it.
Right, right. I mean, I didn't do it during the game. I did it after.
Oh, but yeah.
But it was it was, like I said, it was nice because I didn't have to go find it in the book or, like, you know, go to the other materials I needed because I already made a video of it.
Mm-hmm.
That was also nice, too.
Yeah.
Anything else you wanted to talk about on why we created the channel? Or what it's been doing?
Well, there's always the idea of spreading Go, too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
As someone that in my daily life, the only time I really am with fellow Go players is when I'm in the community, as opposed to someone, you know, was interested in basketball. There's always people that play basketball all around you, or like people that play Hearthstone or something like that. But, you know, Go's not really so popular. And just the more content there is out there, I think the more the game spreads, and we all want that, so.
Right. Yeah, yeah. That's completely true.
Yeah.
What else is there?
Also, we want to put Boston on the map.
That's true. That's not exactly my goal, but it definitely is, like, some of the other members of the crew, like Andrew Hall.
Mm, yeah. It just helps, you know. It's like you might as well mention it as a benefit of this.
True enough. What else is there? I feel like there was more I wanted to talk about.
Well, there's also like all the things about how to teach beginners. I still call myself beginner, double digit Q, whatever. Mm. Like, you know, as a noob, it's tougher to like put ideas into my brain and have them stick, because you know I still suck at Go. So yeah, I think part of it's also like Mikito learning how to like train people. So that's another like benefit.
Yeah, I remember what I wanted to talk about now. I was hoping that more people would join us. I'm hoping to get more single-digit Qs and Dan players to like make videos for this channel. Mm. I don't want it to just be me or you, right? I want like an actual community who will like contribute to, you know, being a scholar of Go or Baduk. Mm. So, yeah. I don't know. That's my pipe dream. We'll see if it comes to fruition.
Let's hope, man.
I think on Reddit, I've got a couple of students. I have two like double-digit Q students who want to learn from me. You already met Romy, and I've made a video about his game once. Mm-hmm. And this other guy, I don't remember his name because we haven't done a lesson yet, but we're supposed to start Monday or Tuesday. I'm a little excited about it. Mm. He's from like another country. I didn't even ask him what country it was, but I'll find out eventually.
Hopefully he speaks English.
He does, at least through typing.
Yeah.
But it would be good to get some different nationalities on this channel too. That'd be fun.
Yeah, that's always interesting, to be honest. And we do tend to do our reviews, or like we talk a lot over Skype, talk about whatever, you know, Go, stuff like that, or when we're ghosting. Those videos are fun. You should definitely check them out. But yeah.
Yeah, so all the videos that I do, they're what I actually study as a single-digit Q player. So you're kind of seeing what I get into, right? Mm. And that's kind of fun, especially with the like ghosting, because it seems like your ideas and my ideas are really different. And so I feel the more we do that, the more you're going to get like, maybe they're not better ideas because I'm not like, you know, a high level Dan player yet, but it's better than like what you're thinking at this time, right?
Yeah, they are definitely better ideas.
But there's still slow moves, but lesser slow moves.
Or like still crazy, but less crazy.
Yeah, yeah. Oh man.
Yeah. Well,
go on.
Go ahead. You first.
Ladies first. That's what I was saying. Like, some of the videos seem definitely out of order, and there's still like parts I haven't finished, like the Fuseki and stuff like that. But it's just because I'm every day I'm like studying something a little new, and I think that's good for diversity.
Mm. And yeah, and you will see more videos from me as well, which will be like short TESG videos. I like to keep everything really concise. You know, I'll teach life and death. I'll teach simple patterns, and yeah, watch out for that.
Yeah, yeah. Dude, I'm wicked excited to work on my Sabaki dancing series. You know, like wave dashing?
Yeah.
Well, I'm calling it Sabaki dancing.
I don't know if anyone will get that reference. In fact, I think nobody will.
So, do you know what Sabaki is?
Yeah, it's like light play.
Yeah, yeah, that's it exactly. It's playing finesse, you know, like moving like water, you know? Mm. And because of that Web Go app video I did, it said that I should learn Sabaki more because it fits with my style of play. Mm. And my Sabaki is pretty crummy, so I'm like wicked excited. I already have like the SGF file laid out, and I already practiced it twice. I just need a little time to get the video done.
Mm, so you've already come out with the Sabaki stuff.
Yeah, yeah. I spent like an hour in like 20 minutes, I think, just learning the first four subchapters of it. And the reason is because it was all on the same pattern. It's just very long. You know, when you're dancing around doing cross cuts and stuff, there's like a crazy amount of variations, right?
Yeah.
So I don't know. I think I'm good at reading and like finessing around, but it, you know, you have to find the key points before you can do that, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So, that's what Sabaki's about. And I know I'm getting off topic about the video. We should probably end it.
Yeah, for sure.
Unless all right. Anything else you wanted to talk about?
Nah, I think I'm all out. Peace out, everyone.
Well, I guess I'll end it with this. Please leave some comments. Hopefully join, you know, us. I'm always free if you ever want to, like, play a game. Feel free to, like, hit me up. And I really do want some, like, more single-digit Q players putting some content on here that's not just me.
Yeah.
So, feel free to come in, teach, grab some students. We'll have some competitions. It'll be fun.
Support your neighborhood double-digit Q, everyone.
All right.
All right. Peace out.